So for a while now, I've been wanting to add something to my computer. I looked at it, but I didn't know what. I thought maybe some RAM, but that's too expensive, and I'm pretty good with the amount I have right now. I thought maybe an RTX graphics card, like the 2080 or the 2080 Ti. But no, those are way too expensive. And then I looked at it again. What about some RGB? Yep, that's what I went for, some RGB. I got three RGB fans right here, 120mm each. They're actually installed right now. They're RGB case fans from Morslin, and these are actually really inexpensive for what they can do. They're 120mm fans, but they have RGB, a lot of RGB, in each fan, and they come with a controller, a remote. I mean, what else could you want? All that for $36 or $35, something like that. That's about $12 per fan. That's really inexpensive. So we're gonna take a look at them, see how they perform and how they look. So make sure to leave a like, a comment down below, and consider subscribing. Enjoy the video. Let's start off with the unboxing experience. You get this box with a couple more boxes inside, and a Molex to SATA cable for power. Inside the little box, you get a fan controller, the remotes, the screws, and the manual, of course. The other three boxes are for the fans themselves. Feeling the fans, they don't feel super premium, but let's remember, you're buying these for about $12 each. The fan blades have this fin design, which I believe is supposed to slightly improve airflow. I'm not completely sure if it works here. Everything is made of plastic. With that said, it doesn't feel like it's gonna fall apart or anything like that. The cables are not your typical 3 or 4 pin connectors. These have like 6 pins. That's why the controller comes with them. I believe the controller allows up to 6 fan connections, so you should be fine if you completely want to fill up your computer with these fans. I like the controller because of the connection amount, of course, but also because it's magnetic. That way, I don't have to screw it in anywhere. I can simply stick it, and if I have to remove it, just take it out. It's simple. And it works perfectly in a case like the NZXT S340 Elite. Before I installed the fans, I wanted to power them with the case open. And man, these things are nice, vibrant, and bright. These are probably the brightest fans I've seen. They have about 12 LED lights in each fan to really make your PC a party. You can adjust their brightness or completely turn them off with the remote whenever you aren't feeling them. With the remote, you can also switch between many modes. I believe it's 16 modes that come installed. You can also choose individual static colors for a more simple look. I like having it on the M5 button. It's like a rainbow look. The other colors also look really nice, and if you have an LED strip inside your case already, they'll look even better. The installation process is very simple. All you need is a screwdriver. These are 120mm fans, so they should be compatible with most cases. They come with the necessary screws. All you have to do is screw them in. The controller gets powered with the included Molex to SATA cable. Just plug it into another Molex cable and plug in the SATA end to the controller. Then plug in the fans to the controller, manage the cable somehow, and power on. It's not hard at all. Gorgeous. Inside a case like the NZXT S340 Elite, they will look really good and stand out. I installed them in places where they would stand out the most, towards the back of the case and in front of my air cooler. Now, these aren't static pressure fans, so I wouldn't recommend putting them on an air cooler or liquid cooler. I did it just for show. Anyway, when running normally, they're silent, no noise at all. But I did notice that when they run at full speed, there is a small jet engine noise. Think of an airplane speeding up, but really quietly. That's what they sound like. It's noticeable, but easy to ignore. The other three fans I have inside of the case make more noise. The performance of these is average. There's nothing special about them when it comes to performance. Their highest speed is only 1000 RPM, which is probably less than something you would want inside an expensive PC like this one. But they're just fine for budget to mid-range PCs. One weird thing that I noticed is that after some time, the color on the LEDs changes. For example, I'll have it on blue, but after like 10 minutes or so, the color changes to green, even though I didn't change it manually. And even though I have it on the static mode. Also, when I had it on the rainbow mode I talked about earlier, the lights just shut off. I don't know what's up with that. So to conclude this video, these fans are not bad at all. For $35, they're a really good option for someone on a budget. Think about it. Once again, $12 per fan with RGB, come with a remote and a controller. What else could you want? That's it for this video. Please make sure to leave a like, a comment down below, and consider subscribing. Thanks for watching, guys.